Teresa, the way you just said yes, it almost sounded as if you were happy.
No, no, no. What I meant when I said yes was yeah, you're right. That Gwen might walk out on you, and yes, you may never see her again. I know how upsetting this is for you.
Then give him the ring back. Can't do it, Mama.
Look, Teresa, I gotta go. Gwen should be waking up soon.
What are you gonna tell her?
I don't know. Just pray for a miracle.
I'm so disappointed in you, Teresa.
Mama, I did the right thing.
How can you say that? By keeping the ring, you're hurting Ethan.
No, I'm trying not to hurt Ethan. Gwen isn't the right girl for him. And without this ring, she's not going to marry him. So I am going to keep this ring right where it belongs, on my finger. Because one day I will be Mrs. Ethan Crane. Last night, I made a promise to God that if he saved McGill's life, I wouldn't come between Ethan and Gwen. Unless Ethan wanted me too.
Then if you made a promise to God, you have to keep it. To break it would be a sacrilege. Give the ring back, Teresa.
But it's a beautiful ring. What would be so wrong with keeping it another day?
Because you made a promise to God. And because you know very well that tomorrow will be too late. You said yourself that if Ethan doesn't give Gwen that ring today, she'll leave him.
Gwen's a fool. I would never leave Ethan, no matter what. I love him, and I would do anything to make him happy.
I don't think that's true.
How can you say that?
Because marrying Gwen would make Ethan happy, and you're trying to prevent that.
No. Ethan only thinks it would make him happy. But I know it wouldn't. Gwen isn't the right girl for him. I am. I know it in my heart.
Teresa,
Mama, I don't want to talk about this anymore. I'm going to go over to the Bennetts and see McGill. By then, Ethan will have talked to Gwen, and my fate with Ethan will have been decided.